Amen. Somebody might miss something there.
Amen.
It's 8:35. Have you ever got spoiled in 30 minutes? I got spoiled already. Amen. 2 Kings 7. 2 Kings 7. 2 Kings 7.
All right.
Amen. Look at verse 5. Verse 5, 2 Kings chapter 7. Amen. Amen. So after, I'm reading out the Message Bible. And so after the sun went down, they got up and went to the camp of Abram. When they got to the edge of the camp, surprise, not a man in the camp. The master had made the army of Abram hear the sound of horses and a mighty army on the march. They told one another, the king of Israel hired, amen, the king of Israel hired the kings of the Hittites and the kings of Egypt to attack us. Panic, they ran for their lives through the darkness, abandoning tents, horses, donkeys, the whole camp just as it was, running for their life. These four lepers entered the camp and went into a tent. First they ate and drank, then they grabbed silver, gold, clothing, and went off and hid it. They came back, entered another tent, and looted it, again hiding their plunder. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And when the sound came,
The people that was in the camp, they ran from the camp. Now, if you go back to the first verse of that seventh chapter, it talks about Elisha made a prophecy. And Elisha said, man, he said, the famine is over.
All right now.
He said, this time tomorrow, you won't have this problem. One of the men said, I guess you think God is going to rain down manna from heaven and we're going to live. He said, the Lord is going to give food. You're going to see it, but yet you won't be able to eat of it.
All right.
Amen. Now, a lot of us, when you look at what God is really doing in our lives and really look at what he's doing, a lot of us doubt.
Come on now.
We doubt the prophecy of God.
Amen.
Amen. God wants to encourage your life. He wants to do something in your life. Amen. Amen. But because of what I'm going through, I doubt what somebody heard me.
Right now.
Amen. I get to a place where I lock myself up in where I am because I don't believe what you. I've been here too long.
Come on now, kill it now.
Amen. If you look at it in the sixth chapter, it talks about Jehovah. And in Jehovah, in the sixth chapter, the 33rd verse, and I'm not gonna read it, but it said Jehovah felt like all.
I'm not saying you don't give, so don't take this wrong. Okay. Amen. Okay, but it didn't wrong now. Please don't take me wrong.
All right.
Don't take me wrong, please. Lord, help me. Okay, I believe in giving, I believe in sowing. I believe.
But when the man said it, it didn't quicken my spirit. Because see, I believe that a lot of times people would see your downfall and dive in on your downfall, because what you really say is, if I just get out.
All right.
So I said my last 273. And God don't move. This is what the Lord said. I was thinking. I said, why? How would I bless Omega this morning with what God has given me? There's some doors that's been shut. There's some doors been shut. Now, what God said is what God said. He said, I need a repentant heart. And I need an obedient heart.
All right.
I need a repentant heart. I need an obedient heart.
Yeah.
Say it again. I need a repentant heart. I need an obedient heart. You say, well, Pastor, see, this is the thing. We do things, and because nobody sees us, we keep moving in those areas, and we never come back to God. God can never say that he wouldn't forgive you.
Amen.
The Bible says my grace is sufficient in all things. So a lot of times we get in things and it might look right, it might even feel right, but it wasn't what God said. Amen. And so what God said is, I need you to repent of that thing of not hearing what I told you.
Okay.
Amen. And then there are some things that we get in that we choose ourselves to get in.
Amen.
Amen. We choose ourselves.
Amen.
To get in. We choose ourselves.
Amen.
To get in. What God said is that when I acknowledge in you that you've chosen some of yourself,
amen,
he said, I need you to come back to me and I need you to have some forgiveness from me, because you have got out of my will and doing what you decided to do. A lot of us is stuck because we have not.
Inside of us that we have not released yet.
And every time God gets us close to a release, I don't think, oh, help me, Holy Ghost. I don't feel like it's going to do no good for me to release it, so I hold it a little tighter. And the only thing the devil has shown you is if you hold it a little tighter, you're going to feel better, you won't get hurt again. Well, you're hurting yourself because you won't let God release you of that thing that keeps holding. See, it's so deep down inside of you.
Amen.
It's so many of us, men and women alone. Amen. There are some boys, some men, amen, that look at their daddy do things at the house. They always say, I'll never be like my daddy.
Tell it now.
Amen. But I found out, whatever you're running from, you run to it.
All right, man.
Whatever you're running from, it's a three. Amen. There's a lot of us, I'm talking me included, there's a lot of us saw our daddies do some stuff that we knew wasn't just, you know. Yeah, the daddy had always been good. We saw daddy do what he did, you know.
Yeah.
Amen. Now some of us saw mamas do some stuff.
Amen.
And we try to close our eyes to it. Amen. I tell ladies all the time, if you're single, you're single and got children, you don't need a lot of men at your house.
Isn't that the truth? Like, you know you're right.
Amen.
You know you're
right. Amen. But your children don't wonder why that. Now you go over there. Amen. And then as a daddy, you can't take your son with you going to somebody else.
Amen. Amen.
Well, because that's the way we grew up. There's a lot of stuff we want to get away from.
Isn't that the truth?
Now, I'm going to tell y'all, if y'all change my whole message, y'all pulling in my spirit right now.
Right.
Y'all change my whole message. I'm telling you, y'all change. This was not in my spirit. Y'all change my whole message. Woo, release me, Lord.
Yeah.
God, let me tell you something. There's some stuff that we saw coming up. I'm talking about 20 years old, 26 years old, you know, you go through this phase of life, and you really want, and there's a lot of guys, there's a lot of guys who want to really take care of their families. But because they saw daddy do so much, it's like a ghost to them.
All right.
This one, my dad didn't do it that way. I ain't doing that. They tell
okay.
Everybody. It's my dad. Who did I marry? Your dad or did I marry you? Because I told my dad this. I told my dad this. My dad called me one day, and he was gonna chastise me about doing something with my wife. So he did. He was gonna chastise me. So we went up to McDonald's and got us some coffee. Amen. He started telling me what I should be doing and everything. And I said, now, either you're going to stay at your house and be the husband at your house, or you're going to be your house and my house, but me and you both ain't going to be here. He looked at me, he said, what you mean? I said, now, you bring me down here to chastise me what I need to be doing. I mean, you can't run my house yours.
All right, now, tell him.
Sometimes you have to release that thing.
Amen.
Now, I don't make stuff up. I don't make stuff up. I don't believe in making it. Some of you got your mama's mentality in you.
Amen.
And I'm not talking about the woman. Some of us guys got our mama's mentality.
All right, now tell me.
Amen. You want to see your wife do what your mama did. You can't do that.
All right. Isn't that the truth?
Oh, glory be God. Try to help.
All right.
You see, if we're gonna ever see the joy of the Lord in our lives,
come on, man.
If we're gonna ever see the overflow of God really do something in us, we have to release some stuff that we've been holding on to too long.
Amen.
We have to release the burden we've held on too long. We have to release that thing. God said, I need you to make a sound.
Mordecai told Esther, he said, if you let Israel die without saying something, if you get quiet now, he said, their blood is going to be on your hand.
Yeah.
He said, you need to say something. Yeah. Esther said, I can't go in and fool with that king. I'm not of this nation. I'm not of this nature. Nation, I'm not of this culture. He said, but you're a pretty woman. Just let them fix you up. Amen. Can you see yourself dressing up sometime and going in? And I know it's not familiar ground to you. I know it's not comfortable to you. But if you fix yourself up and look like God's child, when you go in, you have to say something. And when you say something, that's the release comes when you say something.
Amen.
But if I don't ever say nothing.
All right, now get it.
But I don't ever say nothing. I got to say something. Am I saying something? Well, God, does God get glory out of me saying something? If I just get quiet because I believe that if I'm shut up, then I keep peace.
Amen.
You can't keep peace in times like this.
Amen.
Amen. How do I keep peace by being quiet? You know, the Bible says, in the peace of the Lord, God shall give us his peace. How do God give us his peace? He put us inside. He put himself inside of us.
All right.
And because I got him inside of me, I got peace.
Amen.
Somebody said this peace the world did not give me. This peace, the world. See, a lot of times we're praying and I really want the peace of God. I come into a solution with God. I come into a worship with God. I come into a Shekinah glory with God. And what I really desire, God, I desire God to cover me again. I want God to continue to cover me again. In my covering, God allows his peace to be recognized in me. And every time somebody come against me, God's peace show up in me because his glory is covering me.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
But I need to make a sound.
Yes, sir.
I need to make a sound.
Yes, sir.
Amen. He said, well, Pastor, how do I make the sound? Mouth sound. Now, Adrian singing. He does real good, very well singing. Amen. Sometimes we tune in to him sing. Amen. Sometimes y'all in the same key. It's not your key, he does it, his key. Sing. But do you realize that if your worship is not genuine,
come on now.
If your worship is not genuine where you are, all you're doing is mimicking a song that you can't get a release mimicking.
Come on now, tell it. Tell it now.
Woo.
Yeah, you can't get it. See, you can't do like everybody else is doing. Amen. Y'all remember that song years ago? Y'all might not know. Y'all young people might not know. This song came out years ago. It's not a church song. The man said, it's just my imagination.
Yes, sir.
Running away.
Yes, sir.
Y'all remember the song? Well, when you think about that song, the man made you, when he was singing the song, he made you believe that he was watching somebody passing by. But it wasn't nobody there. It was just in you.
All right now. Hear it?
A lot of times we want God to show up, but because we won't do a real worship, it's just in our minds that he's there. It's just in our minds that he's there. I got to tune in and allow the Spirit of God to rescue where I am. God, I need a release in my life. Go through some doors that have been closed.
Come on, man.
Amen. There's a lot of you here now, and you need a job, or you need this, or you need that, and doors been closed. You know you're qualified or overqualified. You know your money should be right. You ought to be able to negotiate your finances. You should just walk in a place, and they say, well, I'm going to give you $8 an hour. You say, well, okay, I'm in the door. No. You can't give a kingdom man $8 an hour. Negotiate this money. God is about to open some doors.
Come on now.
It's kingdom talk.
Yes, sir.
God want to bless your life.
Yes, yes, he does.
Stop accepting your downfall.
All right now.
Stop letting the devil make you believe you're in the right place. Just stay right there. You know, your mama came up this way. You know, we all been there. But your dad said, no, the devil is a lie. The Bible said, God owns the cattle on the mountain. He don't belong to the Lord. The earth and the fullness of the world belong to God. Now, I don't believe in name and claim, but I do believe whatever your heart's desire, whatever your desire is, God bless your desire.
Yes, it will.
So why should I desire something and doubt it all at the same time?
Isn't that the truth?
I'm praying for somebody, and the only thing I do, I believe my prayer will work on them, but it won't work on me.
All right now.
Paul said, sometimes I encourage myself.
Yes, sir.
I have to lay hands on myself sometimes. Amen. I have to speak to myself sometimes. I speak life into myself sometimes. Why should I always speak life into somebody else? And never speak life on me. Sometimes I get depressed. Sometimes I get down. Sometimes I get down. Sometimes I want to commit suicide. But God have done something in my life. Make some noise. Look here. The Bible said, it said when those men got to walking, he said they come into a place where everything was there.
Yeah.
Woo, they needed something to eat and everything they needed come over, right?
All right.
Amen. Y'all remember when Solomon asked God, he said, all of them, is wisdom to know how to judge your people in and out. And God said, that all you want? Solomon said, that's all I can see right now. God said, you mean to tell me I've been walking with your daddy? Amen. I've walked with the king. I showed you things. And that's all you can say? God told Solomon, he's hanging on his kitchen. He said, I'm going to give you something else. I'm going to give you some money. I'm going to give you some more things. Solomon was a wise man.
Amen.
We had to see that God was releasing something else in him other than what he saw. How many of you can see something else other than what you see? Amen. How many of you can see yourself in another place other than where you are right now? How many of you can see yourself going up to heaven? The Bible says we shall be the living, not the body. We ought to be above and not beneath. Amen. If God is going to do something in my life, see something different than what I see. The Bible said when they went into camp, everything they desired was in the camp. They didn't just get no food for their belly. The Bible said there was some gold there. There was some silver there. Because God didn't just bless you for one day. God blessed you for a lifetime. And you really want a lifetime.
Amen.
You got to make some dollars. You have to make some noise, and I know. See, I know it's in my spirit. There's some of you at your last level of life. Amen. Your money don't look good right now.
Come on.
Yeah, your money don't look good. Relationship don't look good. The house don't look good right now. But if you can praise your way out of it.
Come on now.
Ooh, if you can praise your way out of it. You come on up, baby. If you can praise your way out of where you are. Amen. See, and I'm not talking about just praise your way out while you're here. I'm not talking about, see, there's some times I'm in my car, I let the steering wheel go, and I ain't really out of here. I just let the steering wheel go. I don't let the steering wheel go. I want to shout. I don't let the steering wheel go. I don't know what God done. God showed me such a fast. Come on, you're going to get me. And because he showed me a fast. God wants you to see. God wants you to see it in a different way. Amen. How do I see it, God, in a different way? I told you last Sunday, you have to get up from where you are and start moving from where you are.
Amen.
There's some healing you can take place at your house, but you need to move from where you are. You can't sit still and think God is going to do it just because. No. God wants you to move. Thank you.
bitch. Some of y'all are going home. Some of y'all are going home. When you get home, you ought to try to shout out that show door. You ought to look when you open the door. Y'all ought to put your prayers down. Y'all ought to put your mouth in this door. Let's go shout. Let's go shout. Let's go shout.
Y'all gonna help me. Yeah, yeah. The fool got to see you, God. The Bible said.
Hallelujah. Where you stand? Just where you stand. Just where you stand. God, release it. God, let me release that. There's something going on right now. Now, there's people. There's people that have some sickness in their body. There's some people that have some sickness in their body. There's some things that are here. There's some people that got some sickness in their body. Well, let me tell you this. Because of the mountain God has put on my life. Because of the anointing that's in this place. God is about to release. He's about to release the sickness off your life. And now I'm going to tell you something. This is God. I'm going to say this now. There are some of you that got spirit laying on the hand. You got that gift in you. You got that gift in you. Hey, would you come up front, please? You come up front. There's a gifting. Amen. Now, a few years ago, God put in Abel's hands the spirit of healing. Able to touch you, you will be healed. I'm talking about you. Well, let me say this, baby. I need to tell you this. The Lord said this to me the other day about you. That's the stuff. The reason you can't go to sleep at night. The reason tell you I'm going to go sit down. The reason you can't go to sleep at night because what you did was you pulled back from what God was giving you. Can you pull back? See, that I always tell you. Yeah, so you pull back every time you would touch somebody. Every time you would touch somebody. God will allow his spirit of knowing to fall through you. Well, what you did, you backed up because you got nervous about all the stuff that God was doing right then. Well, God said, now what I need to do, I need to sensitize you. Every person you see, I'm going to call your name, and I'm going to walk up to you. What God said to you, he said, I just need you to touch your head right now. I need you to move on up. That's where it hurt at. And God said that I'm going to be healed just by your hand. And then you go to sleep. He said, then you go to sleep. The reason you can't go to sleep, your spirit is troubled. Because your spirit is not working out what God told you to do. The reason God said it, he said, I got too much work in keeping for you. So I want to pray for you. You want to let me pray for you. You want to let me pray. There's somebody else that's standing here. There's somebody else that's sitting here that need to be prayed for today. You need to pray. If you're coming to the altar, if you just come to the altar, you just... We're trying to get out of here, y'all. We're trying to get out of here. We just... God of mercy, thank you for you. Thank you for the submission of your spirit. You're here, just need to pray for you. I bless God for Adrian, for Ben. I thank God for what he's doing in this hour we're in now. God is taking us to new levels, y'all. He's taking us to new levels. The Spirit of God allowed us to just go through. And when you think about it, we're pushed down, we're pressed down. Amen. The devil want to kill you just where you are. The devil want to take your mind and put you in another place. Because he doesn't really believe that you trust God like you do. Yeah. But because of who he is. Because of what he's shown you in you. Yeah, just because of what he's shown you. You've studied the word. You've been inquisitive about what that means and what's. Yeah. When Joshua crossed the Jordan, God said to him, he said, I need you to put 12 stones there. And he said, I want the 12 stones there to represent the 12 tribes of Israel. And he said, when your children pass by them stones, they will ask, what means these stones? And they will tell them how God brought them out of Egypt. They will tell them how God allowed the Red Sea to open up. And they walked across the dry land. They will tell them how they worship God on the other side. They will tell them how that even though they didn't believe God, God would destroy them. Again, God said this. He said, but they're going to tell them that on the other side, there was land over there that they did not crop, their houses they did not build.
God in here. Pray. We're going to leave God like you did. We're going to leave God like you did. And now, I'm going to tell you this now. I'm going to tell you this later, Holy Ghost. I'm not going to be afraid for whatever they're going to choose in you here. God will heal your whole body.
bless you for what you've done in this place, God. We bless you for what you've done in this place, God. We bless you for what you've done in this place, God. We bless you for what you've done in this place, God. We thank you, God, now. We thank you, God, now. We thank you, God, now. For releasing us. We thank you, God, for all that you've done. We pray, God, now, for your blessings. Lord, as I call you, Lord, God, we pray, God, now, that you will have such a release in this place, God. You will make such a sound, God. Oh, God, I worship you, Lord, with you, God. I pray to be authentic, God. And God, you allow your manifestation to show up in our house, God. To show up on our job, Pastor. To show up in our power, God. We pray, God, now, in the name of Jesus, that increase in heaven's grace in our lives. Thank you, God, right now. Thank you, God, right now. We bless you, Master. We bless you. 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 We bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. 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 We praise what she got, God. We praise the word, we praise the word that she got, God. And may God let us begin to walk in the thought that you've given us. Let her walk in the thought that you've placed in our lives. Let her walk in the thought, God, that you've set around us, God. Not that she will not let nothing, let nothing, let nothing overtake that that you've given us, God. We pray now for now that you begin to increase, God, in every area, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Thank you, Master, right now. We bless you. We praise you. We honor you with all that we have. It's in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Amen. 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 I pray that you will follow us through your hope. I pray that you will follow us through your hope. Amen. Amen. Acts 54. Turn right. Turn left. I got a five minutes. I'm going on the right.